Oh my god, I want to give you something to sit on. You're so tiny. Oh my god.
I like your pillows.
Your little feet might not fit under
the
table.
My goodness. Look, I'm in a booster seat.
We're putting Candace in a booster seat, you guys. Okay?
I'm short.
Okay. Hey fellow beauty finders, it's Mathias for Makeup, and I'm so glad you guys decided to click on today's Monday Makeup Chat. So I'm sitting down with a fellow pro makeup artist named Candace Corey that I want you to meet. She is someone that I've respected and admired from afar because she's from the East Coast. from Chicago, right?
Yeah, based in Chicago.
Based in Chicago. And today she's my guest on my Monday Makeup Chat, and we're going to go over some of our favorite products that you just absolutely have to get your hands on.
Yes.
All right, you guys, so today we're gonna talk about some of our complexion essentials with Candace, and Candace brought out some of her favorites. Let's start with your foundation. What's your favorite foundation or two?
I have two, yeah. My favorite, and I usually use this when I am doing like TV and things like that. This is Temp 2, and they have the Temp 2 pods, which I actually don't use. I use the old school Temp 2 where you pour it into,
yeah, into your airbrush gun.
But I also use it manually. So I'll actually put it on with a brush.
Nice.
And when I want a little bit more coverage, I actually let it sit for a little bit and the pigmentation sits on top of each other, and then I'll pat it out with a beauty blender.
Nice.
Yeah.
And that is a silicone base, right?
Yes, this is the SB.
Very long lasting. Speaking of long lasting, girl, I have heard about this for years and I've never used it, but tell everyone why you like Estee Lauder Double Wear.
This is actually their new Double Wear.
Okay.
This one is a little thinner. This is a stay in place Double Wear, so if you still want the great coverage that you like, this is like full to medium.
Oh.
I actually like to put an oil on my face, mm-hmm. and then I'll put this one and it just glides, but it covers really good because I have a lot of hyperpigmentation.
Nice, okay. And well, not nice that you have hyperpigmentation because I do too.
So if you want to have coverage but it to look like skin, this is great.
Really? Is great. So do they still sell both, or has it been reformulated?
No, they have both. And they love the fact, they have the fact that you have different options. So whichever one that you want, you have.
Okay, so speaking of full coverage makeup, I actually really like the Kevin O'Quinn Central Skin Enhancers. Now you've used these, right?
I mean, these are
incredible. For those of you guys who do watch me on YouTube, you know that I've done many tutorials on Kevin O'Quinn Central Skin Enhancers, but I love them because they're so rich and dense. Yeah. A little tiny bit goes a very long way, and you can use this as a concealer or as a full foundation, depending on the skin type and depending on how much coverage you really need. So I love the Kevin O'Quinn Central Skin Enhancer because they're so kind of versatile.
Now the first time I got that, I was like,
this is so tiny. Why is it foundation?
But it's literally one little dot. It's like your whole face.
I know, a tiny, like a tiny little like needle head size can do like your whole half of your face.
Exactly.
It's amazing. And then speaking of beauty blenders, you know, you did say that you like using a beauty blender.
Yes,
so do I. Essential.
Is pink your favorite?
I think the pink, the original pink, is denser than the new black pro ones.
That's not true.
It's so interesting because I have a black one over there and it feels thinner.
Oh, and how it feels, this might feel thicker, but I find that I go through these faster.
Really?
Yeah, I think it's the color. It because I am constantly like wash.
Okay.
And I have torn up the pink ones a lot faster.
That's so interesting. Yeah. You guys, let me know down below if you guys have the pink one or the black one, the new pro one, and whether or not you guys have had the same problem. How long have you guys had these? Let me know in the comments below.
Yours looks so nice and fresh.
Well, it is. You know, I pulled it out just for you.
All
right. Well, you are special. Oh my God, she came all the way from Chicago, you guys. Hello. So what's next on your must-have list?
Concealer. Have you used It Cosmetics products?
Yes.
I love It Cosmetics
products.
This is their rich concealer, and this is like an orangey kind of color, which I like that.
That's such a good shade.
Yes.
It is.
And with like my hyperpigmentation is really bad around my eyes because I get to rubbing during allergies, and I know that it's going to leave a mark, but I don't care. I get to rubbing. And I like the fact that even though it's thick in the sense of you have good coverage, it's not thick that it's cakey. You can blend it out, and it blends like silk. I love that. So you can get
It Cosmetics makes some really beautiful products, and this color is gorgeous. Yeah. I love that kind of salmon orange undertone. Mm-hmm. So pretty. And the next thing that I want to talk about is cream blush. Now, a lot of my fans and followers and women out there who aren't makeup artists, they don't really use cream blush. They're afraid of cream blush.
Why?
Because they just feel like, I think, that they're not going to know how to rub it in, or they're going to put too much on. Instead, powder is so much easier, I think. But this Ket blush palette, I think, is amazing and a must-have product because it's so versatile. Not only will I use that as a cream blush on somebody, but I can actually take some of these colors and mix them into foundation if I have a client who's really pink.
That's nice.
So many people are so pink, and so many foundations are yellow olive toned out there, because I think MAC started that whole trend in the 90s. It's like, cancel out the red, make everyone yellow green. Oh my gosh, yeah. yes. But you actually need to have a little pink in your skin if your shoulders and your neck are very, very red.
Oh, that's nice.
So it's a wax-based product. A little bit goes a long way. You can use it for lips or cheek, but I just love the pigment. There's actually a lot of pigment payoff, but it's not greasy.
Yeah, it's not greasy.
Yeah, do you feel how it like dried down?
Yeah.
It's like powder almost when it's done.
I'm gonna have to give me some of my cheek.
Okay, let's just touch it off.
I'm a little something.
Yes. Oh my god, look.
It looks nice. This is beautiful. Isn't that nice? Give me some, yeah.
And you can even throw it on your lip.
Yeah. This is my favorite when it comes to concealers. Truthfully, the It was my second favorite. Because I use the Makeup Forever Full Coverage Concealer a lot. Sometimes I use it actually as a foundation.
What do you mix it with? Don't tell me you put that on straight. Do you?
Oh, no. No.
You have to mix it right.
I mix it with like either an oil or a moisturizer.
Nice.
And,
I never tried that.
Yeah, it's really nice. And what I'll do is I'll even dry brush it in areas. So I'll like put a moisturizer on. I'll just kind of dry brush in certain areas as a foundation. And I'll put it on straight just where it's in spots. So it's acting like a concealer, but I'm doing it really softly. So I want to look like that no makeup look.
Right.
Yeah, where you show a little bit of imperfections, not too perfect, but still kind of cover up a lot of the stuff. I like to use it for that. But I even use this when I'm doing airbrush, because I will do it under the eyes and around the mouth, and then I'll airbrush them.
And what a lot of people don't know about this is I'm willing to almost bet that this was like the first waterproof full coverage concealer out there.
Now
there's a few, you know, Kat Von D has one, and I think Too Faced just came out with one, but this is like the original. This has been around for almost 15 years, I think. I've loved this forever. This is so good. And this covers up tattoos. Like,
oh, yeah.
It literally can cover up a bruise or a tattoo. That's a great product. Sometimes when you want the skin to glow, but you don't want to look like a sparkle dome.
Oh.
You know, you don't want to use highlighter all over your face.
Right.
I actually really like the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish. I don't like a ton of MAC products. Oh, my God. I can't believe that. Oh, my God. Something about the Mineralized Skin Finish is the one thing that they still do that no one else does.
Oh, my goodness. It is a
mineralized pressed powder that gives a subtle sheen to the entire face.
You know, I'm gonna ask you for
something. Oh my gosh, it is so, so pretty. Okay, watch.
Be dark. But that's nice.
But do you see what it does slightly?
That's beautiful.
Like it adds a subtle sheen, so the light will hit you and it'll look like skin.
That's
so
nice.
I use it to kind of like do a finish set. I don't use it on every single client, but sometimes, you know, if the client says, oh, I'm feeling a little powdery. Because sometimes, a client will say, I'm feeling a little powdery, and they're going for a press event or red carpet.
Mm-hmm.
I go, oh, let me get some mineralized skin finish. And I dust it all over their face, and it gives them a little more sheen without adding any more hydration, which is then going to make them look greasy on the skin. So it's kind of like a finishing powder.
I'm going to totally steal that trick.
Yeah.
This powder, a lot of times, and it's funny, other makeup artists laugh at me for having this, but this is CoverGirl's face powder. I like the clean, and they have one that's that actually helps absorb excess oil. I don't like that one, though.
Okay.
That's okay.
We throw that away.
Yeah. But I actually like the clean, and the reason why, this is like extremely light, but I'm going to put some on the back of my hand, and I'm going to show you how it goes in like nothing. See how that is? So if I'm doing someone's face, I like it as almost like a translucent.
Okay.
And the more you use it, it can cover more.
Yeah.
I don't like the white high def powders, because if you aren't looking properly and you get on camera, they look like they have like ghosts on their face.
It's so weird. Yeah, those white high def powders, that camera sees something else than we see.
Yeah, I don't like that.
Really careful.
So that's my favorite. Because it's nice and clean.
Awesome. I hope you guys enjoyed this week's Monday Makeup Chat. As always, I would love to hear your comments down below. So please do leave me a comment. Click thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. And if you're not following us both on social media, we are pro makeup artists with tons of experience. So you've got to subscribe to our Periscope and our Facebook live streams. Also, Twitter, Snapchat. We got to do some Snapchats together. She does a ton of behind the scenes on her Snapchat and our Instagram accounts. So please do follow us on social media. We also both have YouTube channel, so I'm going to put her link down below in my description so you can check her out on her YouTube channel. And when are you coming back? Because I just need to have you in my life.
I'm going to come back next month so we can do some other stuff. Next time, I'm going to have him do stuff on my channel of doing makeovers and things like that.
Oh my God, I can't wait. I love doing makeup. So I definitely want to see you soon, and I want to see you guys next time. So please subscribe by clicking on that link down at the bottom. And stay tuned for two more videos right after the break.